who is educated up to 5th standard, occupied as a laborer, and he is resident of Ujire district, Karnataka. History was given by patient and his mother. Chief complaint, complaint of dyspnea on exertion from 2 years, complaint of bluish discoloration of skin and mucous membrane from 1 year, and complaint of violet.
1 year or last 1 year?
From last 1 year, sir.
Okay, 1 year.
And yes. Bilateral lower limb swelling from last 2 months.
Mm. 2 months, okay, fine.
Yes, sir. History of presenting illness. Sir, there is important childhood history in my patient, so I would like to describe it first. Patient was born of a non-consanguineous marriage, full term normal vaginal delivery at home. There were no perinatal complications and no history of maternal infection or prolonged drug intake during pregnancy. As per patient's mother, during infancy, patient was admitted to the hospital for complaints of hurried breathing, cough and fever about near 3 to 4 months of age, and was treated with IV medications and nebulizations. At this time, mother was told that the child is having a hole in heart and will need surgery for it. And also there was history of similar type of hospital admissions about 4 to 5 times up to 2 years of age. After that, patient was asymptomatic till 30 years of age.
What happened? Recurrent lower respiratory infection in a child.
Only 2 years of age, sir.
Up to?
2 years of age.
Oh, 2 years of age, okay.
Yes, sir. 2 years of age. At that time, there was no history of feeding difficulty or suck cycle or sweating over forehead. And after that, patient was asymptomatic till 30 years of age. And now patient has complaint of dyspnea on exertion from last 2 years, insidious in onset, gradually progressive. Initially was on walking of more than 1 kilometer, climbing more than 3 flights of stairs, and gradually progressed now over period of 2 years. So that patient is having now marked dyspnea on his usual work at his workplace, which is interfering with his work. But there is no dyspnea at rest. There is complaint of bluish discoloration of skin and mucous membrane from last 1 year, which is involving all 4 limbs and tongues and lips. And complaint of bilateral lower limb swelling from last 2 months. Swelling are up to ankle, and patient is telling is feeling more toward end of the day, and it disappears on waking up on the morning. And no complaint of orthopnea or PND, no complaint of cough or hemoptysis, no complaint of chest pain or palpitation, no complaint of giddiness or loss of consciousness, no complaint of headache, blurring of vision, any limb weakness or seizure, no complaint of any prolonged fever. Sir, growth and development history.
No, any hemorrhoid diathesis, any bleeding diathesis?
No, sir, no bleeding diathesis.
Okay.
Yes, sir. Sir, growth and development history.
Synotic heart disease patient, no, you have to describe this, no, many things like, first of all, these symptoms of hyperviscosity and any blood letting and symptoms of any hematological or any hemorrhagic diathesis.
Yes.
Okay, not fine.
No, I had the complaint of headache or bleeding of vision or limb weakness was there.
In any history of any intracranial abscess or any. What is headache? Why do you have a headache? Or what is the cause of headache in case of synovial glandular disease?
Sir, headache, one, it can be due to hyperviscosity symptom. Other, it can also be due to intracranial complications like brain abscess, or there may be cortical venous sinus thrombosis, or there may be CV stroke because of paradoxical embolism.
मार्क्स हो गया क्या?
यस सर. ग्रोथ एंड डेवलपमेंट हिस्ट्री. पेशेंट्स मदर डिड नॉट रिपोर्ट एनी ग्रोथ डिले एंड पेशेंट अचीव्ड डेवलपमेंटल माइलस्टोन एप्रोप्रिएट फॉर एज. सिबलिंग हिस्ट्री. पेशेंट हैड टू एल्डर ब्रदर्स, बोथ आर हेल्दी एंड नो देर इज नो सिग्निफिकेंट फैमिली हिस्ट्री प्रेजेंट. पर्सनल हिस्ट्री. पेशेंट इज मिक्स बाय डाइट, एपेटाइट एंड स्लीप आर नॉर्मल, बॉवेल ब्लडर हैबिट आर नॉर्मल एंड नील एडिक्शन.
ओके. सो एवरी पेशेंट वेरी हैव सिम्टम्स ऑफ शॉर्ट ड्यूरेशन 2 इयर्स ओनली ओनली 2 इयर्स
यस सर.
दिस व्हाई एवरी इज ब्रेथलेसनेस. यू टोल्ड पेशेंट इज मार्कली डिसने. Why is he listening? He has got no pulmonary venous apparatus and pieces not there.
Yes, sir.
I mean, disease not, no, you have no pulmonary venous pressure normal here, is it? No pulmonary venous pressure is.
Yes, sir. Sir, we are considering, because patient is also having history of cyanosis and infantile history of respiratory tract infection, so we consider cyanotic congenital heart disease. In these such cases, because of hypoxia, there is stimulation of the respiratory centers and the chemoreceptors present in brainstem and aortic arch and carotid body. This leads to tachypnea and sensation of dyspnea.
Mm. Okay. How the patients get relieved from dyspnea? Are you taking rest or in assuming some squatting posture or on taking rest only?
On taking rest only. He did not tell any about any squatting, sir.
Okay, fine. So, tell me what diagnosis you are putting forth.
Yes, sir. So, considering this history, the infantile history of early childhood history of frequent respiratory infections, and now again patient developing symptom of dyspnea and cyanosis. So I'm considering here, sir, congenital heart disease. Initially, patient was having shunt physiology, left to right shunt, and now has developed Eisenmenger physiology. And it can be, sir, pre-tricuspid level, considering patient's age of presentation.
But you told that when you develop respiratory infection, pre-tricuspid aren't having so much lower respiratory infection admitted in the hospital. Mm.
Yes, sir. Up to 2 years of age. Yes.
That too we develop. That too we. It only is 2 years of age. Eh? Thereafter, it is maximum until 30 years of age.
Yes, sir.
Why do you think like that? Pre-tricuspid sound, even asymptomatic after 2 years of age, why the patient develops so much speech early?
Yes, sir. This is
pre-tricuspid sound, HD or what? HD or TB thing? What do you think? Pre-tricuspid sound or many things, na? Tell me, what are the pre-tricuspid sounds?
Pre tricuspid includes ASD, ASD with PAPVC, TAPVC,
PAPVC also, PAPVC intact IS. No?
Yes.
So, what do you think of from HD? Which variety of sound you are thinking?
Sir, it may be ASD.
But why the patient develops so much of respiratory infection that you recount respiratory infection admitted, hospitalized, getting oxygen, and that will become asymptomatic 2 years of age? Why? What the pathophysiology here becoming symptomsless at age of 2 years?
For isolated ASD, sir, it goes against this point. Otherwise, if it is ostium primum like ASD or ASD with PA PVC or very large ASD, it can be there. But
again, at 2 years space, they would develop stomas PS. Even before 5 years space, stomas PS in ASD patient develop whatever may be ASD, PA PVC, probably single atrium or a common atrium or ostium primum ASD.
Yes, sir. So that's why, sir, post-tricuspid we can also not deny at this stage.
Then why not post-tricuspid? Because yes, the yeah, only, if you are still continued, okay, you have like respiratory infection continue for 10 years, 13 years, like that. And that was yes. how often the case of ASD patient develop a recurrent respiratory infection and requires hospitalization.
Yes, sir. It is very less common in ASD. That way, I also like to put post-tricuspid shunt.
Oh, no. There is someone on your editorial has described all the hoops sounds not because zebras, no? All the irregular fever for continuous for a long time is not because of brucellosis. You have tuberculosis. Could you brucellosis? Yes. So you should go by commonness. It may be wrong.
Yes, sir.
So go by commonness. So patient become asymptomatic at the age of 2 years. So past should be post tricuspid can't be tricuspid from ASD.
Yes.
Okay, continued for like this and the frequency also diminished, but it's continued for 4-5 times a year, continue for 10-12 years, 13 years. Okay, you can think of like this. But still I won't think of ASD from ASD.
Yes.
The age of 2 years, patient asymptomatic means patient develop significant PAs which curtail the QP such extent that patient becomes symptom free.
Yes, sir.
So, depending on history, you should tell that okay, there is sound physiology because there is diagnosis of sound, not patient cyanosis, sound physiology, but I'm thinking of distal to post-tricuspid sound. Why late? So which patient did exam? Why late after? No, late. See, patient develop asymptomatic in 2 years. See, patient not late.
Yes, sir. Late.
You said this is become asymptomatic. This develop at 2 years.
Yes.
Yes,
sir.
Depends upon many factors. Progression of disease depends on many factors.
Yes. So
there could be large sound. Initial large hole. That the hole come down. Hole matter size matter come down.
Yes, sir.
So, patient is asymptomatic from 2 years to 30 years.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay, you're right. Which type of pre-tricuspid sound developed PH frequently? Okay, HD with PAPVs. But at the age of 2 years now, HD PAPVs. Single atrium. But these are single atrium, again, you have to have sinuses. No sinuses on the early side.
Yes.
Only one interesting history in your presentation is that is if patient has a pre-tricuspid sound, then no history is suggestive of heart failure. Left heart failure is not there. Only
yes.
Patient has increased pulmonary blood flow history there. No, there is a repeated respiratory infection, but the no history suggestive of heart failure.
Yes.
So that is there. But again, the patient had become asymptomatic at age of 2 years. Very difficult to explain in the term of pre-tricuspid sound.
Yes, sir.
So what are the types of sound-related PAs, you know? There are four types of sound-related PAs. You know that? You know, no?
That's one is the because of hyperkinetic pulmonary artery hypertension related to shunt. Second one is the due to development of Eisenmengerization. Third one is the due to the shunt is a bystander lesion. It is not contributing to the development of pulmonary hypertension in the patients. And fourth is the pulmonary artery hypertension that develops or persists or progress after the correction of the shunt.
Yeah, you told four types. Only thing you change the order. So first is hyperkinetic phase.
Yes,
sir.
Yes,
sir. So what is the difference between hyperkinetic phase and isomagnetic phase?
Hyperkinetic pH is to increase pulmonary blood flow. There will be symptoms of respiratory tract infections and cardiomegaly will be there present. And in fixed obliterative pH, there will not be features of increased pulmonary blood flow. Cardiomegaly will not be there. And sir, main feature there, flow murmur will be absent in case of mid-diastolic flow murmur will be absent in case of obliterative pH.
Suppose this case I've given you some hemodynamically, we'll discuss the case. Happening yeah. pH, suppose the pH happening pH versus pH with the isomer pH, part of the pH pressure. Now, the person you take the pressure, blood pressure in the upper limb, blood pressure in the right arm, you got it 110 by 70, okay?
Yes, sir.
And I'm talking BHD, case I have BHD. Tell me hyperkinetic pH what the PA pressure and obstetric pH what the PA pressure. Just I'm not telling that exactly. So I want to know, I want to understand. I want to know how much you have got hemodynamic any concepts. Hyperkinetic pH is BHD and isomer pH is BHD and blood pressure 110 by 70.
Sir. Pulmonary artery pressure in case of main pulmonary will be more than 25 millimeter mercury in pulmonary hypertension.
Both are pulmonary hypertension. I give you the blood pressure between 110 and 70 or right pulmonary blood pressure. In outer pressure 110 and 70. Out of pressure 170, what could be PPS in hyperkinetic pH and put PPS in isomer pH?
Data I don't know, sir.
Chetan, are you there?
I'm here. Sir, in non-restrictive VSD, if blood pressure is 110 by 70, means LV pressure will be 100. So RV pressure will be 100 and PA systolic pressure will be also 100. And if we consider RV end diastolic pressure around 7 to 8, so this is hyperkinetic pH. So there will be wide pulse pressure between in PA. Diastolic pressure should be pulse pressure should be more than 60% of systolic pressure. So PA end diastolic pressure will be around 40. So mean will be around 60, sir.
And fixed pH, general pH.
White pulse pressure will be less. There will be no white pulse pressure. So diastolic PA pressure will go up, and transpulmonary gradient will be more than 7, sir.
Diastolic gradient.
Sorry, diastolic pulmonary gradient. Sorry, sir. There will be no white pulse pressure.
So, you understood your name is Kashyap.
Yes, sir.
You understood short. Suppose the patient has got PA. See, person had hyperkinetic pH. Only the systolic pressure is raised. Systolic pressure is PA systolic pressure equal to your RV systolic pressure.
Yes, sir.
If you think about a non-restrictive PhD, even you also some amount of mild restrictive PhD or something, no? Your LV pressure 110, RV pressure is 100, supposing. Or 90, even 90 also. So, PA will be 90. If it's non-extreme BHD, P equal to RV. Okay, take it a non-extreme BHD. So LV 110 and RV 110 and P is 110. But as the hyperkinetic pH, so patient has not developed obliterate changes, pulmonary vascularization is not elevated much. So diastolic pressure is not raised.
Yes.
So diastolic pressure little more, maybe little more than that your pulmonary voice pressure. So maybe 90 by 30, 90 by 20, something like that. White pulse pressure because the pulmonary vascular resistance is low. Once patient develop changes in the pulmonary circulation, there is ovulatory changes and there is cavernous malformation in the pyxoderm lesion. So, and there is decrease density of the capillaries and small arteries. So your diastolic pressure will go. So pulse pressure become narrow.
Yes, sir.
Pulse become narrow. So the pulse pressure will be less than 40% of your systolic pressure.
Yes, sir.
When pulse pressure will become narrow, or when the diastolic pressure is goes up, all the diastolic pressure, you would think the patient is approaching towards agile mode.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so first diagnosis, the shortened pH is your Eisenmenger, second is hypercapnia, third is bystander, as we told. There it is, but this shunt is the shunt is small enough to explain the pH. And fourth is progression of pulmonary hypertension after intervention, after closure of the defect.
Yes, sir.
After four is more dangerous, fourth is more malignant. So there is early progression of fat pillar and death. That behaves like idiopathic pH.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so why not it's a case of, why do you think of pH? Why not it's a case of VHD pH?
Sir, in VHD pH, there will be, means acquired VHD pH is there, acquired pH, then at this age, majority they will be asymptomatic, and if they become symptomatic, main symptom will be dyspnea on exertion. Cyanosis will be very uncommon in these patients, and also this is the main reason. Otherwise,
you might have developed some acute obstruction at age of 2 years, so that reduced pulmonary blood flow, and over the years, over the progression of disease, now developing cyanosis, right?
Sir, majority of patient they behave like reduced left to right shunt only, such patients.
No, that should be, no. See, why I'm asking, why I'm discussing this, no? It has the left right shunt. That's significant enough to produce respiratory infection, but not enough to produce heart failure. Patient has no history of heart failure. Mother told no history of heart failure. That's sucking, sucking without any difficulties, as mother used to feed the baby without any difficulties, no poor sweating, no tachypnea, nothing. So there are no histories of the heart failure, there is no history of failure to gain weight. So what I'm thinking, there is some amount of obstruction, maybe there is not enough. Understand? But enough to have a left right shunt and their shunt related infection. Now, would you slowly progression of the RV with the obstruction? Now, the patient become cyanotic and is necrotic. You understand my question?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. At this point, we cannot differentiate, sir, probably from history.
Yeah, only thing that you got a definitely early history, early history of cyanosis, because 32 years very. Too much it is out of gap there. So we would have developed cyanosis and symptoms much earlier.
Yes, sir.
Only thing that. But that is also some, though it is not very common, but when second time, so we can keep it.
Yes, sir.
Okay, this is straightforward case because patient has got only thing that you should not tell is a case of pre-tax person. Because only has become asymptomatic 2 years of age. So that's why I'm thinking a lot of pre. You can't think of pre-tax or something.
Yes, sir.
Okay, finding what exam is finding?
Sir, general examination. Patient is conscious, cooperative, and well-oriented to time, place, and person. Height is 160 centimeter. Weight is 50 kilogram. BMI is 20 kilogram per meter square. Temperature is normal. Pulse is 88 per minute, regular rhythm, normal volume, no radio radial or radio femoral delay. All peripheral pulses well felt. blood pressure 120 by 80 in right upper limb, 126 by 80 in left upper limb, 130 millimeter aim of mercury in lower limbs. Respiratory rate is 20 per minute, regular abdominothoracic. JVP is 6 centimeter from sternal angle of Lewis. It's 11 centimeter of water and 8 millimeter of mercury with prominent A wave, normal descents, and normal respiratory variation. Central cyanosis is present. Grade 2 clubbing is present, pan-digital clubbing. SpO2 is 83% in all four limbs. Conjunctival suffusion is present. Bilateral pitting pedal edema just above ankle present. No icterus, no lymphadenopathy, back and spine normal, no facial dysmorphism, oral cavity hygiene is normal.
Okay.
Yes. Systemic examination on in cardiovascular system, inspection and palpation. Chest is bilaterally symmetrical, trachea is central, apex bit is in left fifth intercostal space on mid-clavicular line, diffuse with lateral retraction, RV type of apex. Palpable second heart sound is present in left second intercostal space. Parasternal heave grade 2 present. Epigastric pulsations RV type present. No dilated veins, scar or sinuses. On percussion, upper border of liver dullness is in right fifth intercostal space in mid clavicular line. Stomach tympani on left side. Apex coincides with left heart border. Right heart border is retrosternal. Left second intercostal space is dull. On auscultation.
Left second central dull, where it is? Dull where? Dactyla or in parasternal?
Just lateral to the sternal border, left second intercostal space. Yes. On auscultation, first heart sound is normal. Second heart sound is single and loud. It is P2. Ejection click is present in left second intercostal space, just lateral to the sternal border. It does not vary with respiration. There is one pan-systolic murmur is present at lower left sternal border. High pitch, blowing, plateau configuration, grade 2 by 6. It does not change with respiration or leg raising. There is no S3 or S4 and no other murmur. On other systems are normal, sir.
No murmur in the back, I think. So, pulmonary is a click and you get a TMO more.
Yes.
So, what is your final?
Diagnosis. Yes, sir.
We got a click and acyclic non-variable disconstant click. We got a paroxysmal lower down 2x6 only. 2x6.
Yes, sir.
Not very great murmur, no?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Sir, it is situs solitus levocardia, post tricuspid shunt, probably VSD, with features of right heart failure. In patient in functional class 3 with sinus rhythm and no evidence of infective endocarditis.
Only thing that now, what is a pulmonary edema? Which pulmonary edema? There is just a click or outy click and no murmur. So if you have the early atrial murmur, no doubt. No, yesterday they got early atrial murmur, so there is no doubt about that. Eisenmenger physiology. But even they are not getting any kind of murmur in pulmonary area. There is no evidence of that, even here.
Yes.
What do you think of VSD pulmonary disease. Now, 30 years of age, now I'm going to ask you now. Long time VSD pulmonary disease, or long time you're top physiology. VSD is not there. And VSD is not there.
Yes, I didn't get that.
You're expecting or no?
Yes, I was expecting because patient is in features of right heart failure, pedal edema, raised JVP.
So why don't you call me VSD pulmonary disease?
Usually TR murmur we don't get right heart failure.
No, I am not getting TR murmur. I am not convinced that patient has got PH and TR. PH here.
Sir, there is a
second term.
Yes, sir, there is dull not.
QT is absent here. No, I am thinking that.
There are features of pulmonary hypertension are there, like parasternal heave is there, grade 2 epigastric pulsations are there, left second intercostal space is dull. All the features of pulmonary hypertension. So in pulmonary atresia, we don't get such features.
Okay. Please ask my question. What is the right ventricle? What is the right ventricle?
Yes. Right ventricular pressure will be similar to the systolic blood pressure, sir.
Then what is the blood pressure? You have already recorded. So what is the RV pressure like?
RV pressure would be 120 millimeter mercury systolic.
No.
In VSD pulmonary atresia, sir.
Let us presume it.
It will be same, sir.
Same, sir. Then what? We both are same, sir. If a person is getting there, we could have got here also.
These features are reflection of pulmonary artery hypertension we are getting.
You are not getting any pulmonary murmurs, you are not getting any EM also. I say no, there is no pulmonary. So how can I download getting a left second cell?
We don't get sir usually.
Pulmonary patient I got no single ventricular pulmonary atresia.
Yes. Yes, sir.
Any mass patient get atresia? Get it? Why not?
Yes, sir.
Why not, sir? Why not? So, very difficult to differentiate because you are not getting any evidence of direct evidence of pedilatation. You are getting only second space in down. So usually out of avenue dilated also won't get left second space down note in case of BHP polymeritis unless there is yield malpassion gratuitous.
Yes.
You have to take a history into account. So history is there from beginning, there is a hole in the heart and the history suggests of the left heart some significant signs. So now patient develop VHP, not VHP pulmonary atresia. And that too, VHP pulmonary atresia, patient is alive to this years, you have to get evidence of collaterals, automatal, no, marker, major outflowing collaterals. So not getting evidence.
Yes.
There are no evidence of automatic collaterals.
Yes, sir.
You have to make argument like this.
Yes, sir.
Otherwise, very difficult to do because there is no ED. When you want to click there,
yes.
You get a click, outer dilated, you get out vascular click, and single sound single because PP is absent. And because outer dilated, and the right LV stroke output, biminal stroke output will be great big. So you may get A2 very loud also because outer dilated and the elastic recoils outer is brisk, you may get A2 loud. So, understand?
Yes, sir.
So VHD, why not you told at beginning HD there, no? You told, why not why you change your diagnosis now, VHD? Why not HD, ETP, PVC? Something like that, so has given rise to Eisenmenger. Why not HD?
Sir, mainly
TR goes in favor of HD integrated TR. So all the TR gani first leap there and from and JVP, A is greater than V, and why not it is HD?
Mainly on second heart sound, in ASD Eisenmenger, we will get a wide fixed split with loud P2. Here I am getting single second heart sound. Otherwise, no other points against ASD is the major.
Otherwise, no other point against, correct. Okay, only the sound, you have to discuss the case, like you don't give diagnosis and just see. So you have to take these cases of central TPS. Discuss like this, so I'm getting these things from the way my perspective there. I'm going in for each, but second sound is single, which usually gets single sound is split, both feature expression, and it is when fixed up. So it is very important sign for each as manga, I'm not getting it. Whereas the other findings are in favor of each as manga, but VHD, second sound single, and from the way and first lift. So partially nothing. RV impulse only. RV are getting apex or same impulse getting in partial area. So understand. So only thing that your second sound single is goes in favor of strongly goes in favor of VHD as in member or AP window as in member. AP window as in member. Could it be AP window? First of all. AP window as in member what?
It usually as in member. In first decade of life, they will not present so much later.
Why? What's the reason behind it? Only BHT has the equipment same, no? Lipterson. One thing is inside, is outside heart.
So there will be both, the shunt will be both in systolic and diastolic phase. In VHD only shunt will be then systolic phase. So increase amount of pulmonary blood flow. It will lead to early Eisner meningitization in AP window.
Pressure and volume both transmitted. Both systole diastole pressure as well as blood transmit flow or transmit the pulmonary circuit. So patient get early yes. So everything is same thing. Second sound single and you may get and inform sinuses and periodic sinuses or ear can inform sinuses. Only thing that is only thing that you got early.
Yes.
Otherwise, clinically very different depression between between Eisenmenger and based Eisenmenger.
Yes, sir.
You describe all simple Eisenmenger, HD, VHD, and PD. as in my girlfriend in panel test, almost 40 because person has become asymptomatic at age 2 years and second son single and I'm thinking one now person is going to have failure right at home. Usually the most, usually they survey up to even 40, 50, 55 years age as in my girl. And more of death is that day to hemoptysis, not hemoptysis. Hemoptysis is not caused by the death. It is heart failure, sudden cardiac death.
Yes.
But with arrhythmia, which is the cause of, or common causes more of death.
Yes, sir.
To describe these things. Maybe it's not a complex angiomyogram or not a, not no, but, like Eisenmenger has developed so late, it's not other type of Eisenmenger.
Yes.
Could it truncus better? What's called truncus?
Sir, also in same truncus artery, says majority of the patients die within first year of life because of congestive cardiac failures, 90% mortality within first.
They'll ask you the question like this. What is what are the conditions you get second sound single? Once the question asked, you should not take any time lag period. No lag period.
Yes, sir.
The question is finished from the exam's mouth and you start answer. Within 3 seconds, you complete the answer.
Yes, sir. Sir?
One second.
In all cardiac conditions, should I tell, sir? In
non-cardiac conditions, or sir, I don't mind.
Yes, sir. Sir, single second heart sound will be there in this... severe aortic stenosis, severe pulmonary stenosis, and in patient with severe pulmonary artery hypertension.
Answer, horrible answer. Severe aortic stenosis, you will get single second heart sound. Patient back of the heart valve, I will get very nice paratical speed. Will get. But you see, go to common company, they start with BH pulmonary artery, absent pulmonary valve, go like this.
Yes, sir. The other causes are sir, single valve like truncus arteriosus, that will be single. Then patient with tetralogy of Fallot, it will be single because pulmonary component is not audible. Then patient is having either TGA or CCTGA because the anterior post aorta and posteriorly placed pulmonary trunk will get single. And severe pulmonary hypertension will give single second heart sound.
Severe pulmonary hypertension will single heart sound. Suppose the patient has got a heart attack. All single heart sound. Narrow spin will get no heart single heart sound.
Means sir, in case of VSD, we can get single heart
sound. I don't tell that, no.
Yes, sir.
Meet Eisenmenger, single ventricular Eisenmenger, that's different.
Yes, sir.
Fever is severe Okay, so what is
ECG
with you?
Send ECG
person or
you can... Yes, sir. ECG is
Yes, sir. This is a 12-lead ECG with normal standardization. And it is showing, sir, QRS axis is near 120 to 130, plus 120 to plus 130 degree. There is a P pulmonale is present, sir. And, sir, there is a
Listen, listen, don't mention pulmonary. Right atrial abnormality mention. Don't mention pulmonary. Pulmonary, P congenital, don't mention. Right atrial abnormality is there, but right atrial enlargement can say also.
Right atrial enlargement is there. And sir, there is incomplete right bundle branch block with RVH with the strain pattern is there, sir. And there is an absence of in Q wave in V5, V6, sir. And that's it. And sir, it is, sorry, sir, it is a sinus rhythm with the rate is around 80 beats per minute, sir.
So incomplete RVB is how to diagnose RVH in the presence of incomplete RVB?
Sir, in present of incomplete RVB, if the R wave amplitude in lead V1 is more than 10 millimeter is there, then we say it is RVH is present, sir.
Okay, so RVH. So X-ray.
X-ray is there. Can Bhushan, can you show the X-ray or just I read, sir?
Yeah, X-ray I'm seeing now. X-ray, X-ray also, Bhushan, X-ray now. Okay, X-ray I'm seeing. X-ray just you can get.
Yes, sir. X-ray, plain X-ray, chest PA view with slightly rotated film. With sir, cardiac silhouette appears near mildly enlarged, and RV type of contour is there, and main pulmonary artery is hugely dilated, right pulmonary artery is hugely dilated, and the peripheral pruning of pulmonary vasculature is seen, sir.
How to pulmonary window? Radial screw window. Outer pulmonary radial window, it is obliterated or it is there. I'm not able to become get very small, very minuscule picture here. Show me the outer pulmonary radial window. Outer pulmonary radial window. This is outer. This is sorry, trachea. Go down. Down. Trace from outer to outer gas to pulmonary artery. That is your window. That is obliterated or not obliterated? So, what do you think of seeing ECG and X-ray? What is your diagnosis?
Sir, it more goes in favor of pre-tricuspid ASD as a manger.
Yes, it looks like ASD as a manger. RPA dilated too much. Eh? RPA dilated. Yes, and P also dilated. So, it looks like the contour looks like as if it is ASD as a manger. Only thing that RA not much in RPA.
Yes, sir.
Are you not enlarged? It is alien large there or is it rotated film?
It
is play or it is RA or it is rotated film? Because are you not enlarged?
Slightly rotated film.
What, Bhushan, are you able to see the X-ray there?
Yes, sir.
Rotated film and scoliosis also, sir.
Scoliosis is there. So from X-ray and EC is to seems like ECG as a pre-traction, no?
Yes, sir.
EC is RBB there, including RBB, and here your looks like no. Others are able to see. Everybody seeing able to X-ray? Yes, sir. Everybody will see.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Oh, yes, sir. I'm only seeing. Okay, fine.
So.
Yeah, correct. Okay, echo, read out echo.
Yes, sir, full echo report I don't have, sir. Just, sir, it was, yes, sir, septaver intact, sir, both interatrial and interventricular septaver intact, and PDA was there, sir, large PDA.
That I'm telling you, sir, outer pulmonary window looks obliterated to me here. See? Out of pulling window, there's no space at all. I'm seeing very small helium. And L is yours in last, L. not RA. Really large and outer palm window totally obliterated.
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. You have to discuss like this. Okay.
Yes, sir.
You can discuss.
Yes.
Goes like this.
Yes, sir.
But you have to mention somewhere else. So all HD, BHD, PD, you have to, and you have to this one. You have to discuss one by one.
JVP, because IVS is intact. In AP window, can we get sir raised JVP sir? Because IVS is
intact. Same, but RPS is same beginning RPS equal no. JVP won't raise any none of the cases.
AP window also. Yeah. Yes sir.
Only thing that you what that early first only early very early is manifestation. No, that's only thing. AP window.
Yes.
Here JVP is raised because you had pillar. Patient have heart failure now.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Tier won't get agent member post-tax tier won't get only patient go to RF dilatation. RF, any pressure overload and ventral dilatation is there is failure. Out stenosis, if you get cardiomegaly, brain out stenosis, cardiomegaly, failure dysfunction. Otherwise, severe out stenosis, even though gradient is more than 100-120 mm mercury, but there no cardiomegaly, failure systolic function is retained. Once the cardiomegaly starts, RV dysfunction. Similarly, RV, whatever is RV, RV pressure, there if no cardiomegaly, RV function normal. If RV start dilate, RV dysfunction. So there here TR because RV dysfunction. And there is cardiomegaly.
Yes.
Cardiomegaly is actually 32 years man, yes, but as a member. And only thing that you have to see the outer pulmonary window is so nicely it is occulted. And LA is also enlarged. So outer I can't see the outer enlargement. But outer pulmonary window is radio window is occulted.
Yes, sir.
Discussion will go like this. But if you say PD Eisenmenger, you won't get much credit also. If you not tell PD Eisenmenger, not losing any mark. But we have to discuss everything. PD Eisenmenger, like get BHD Eisenmenger, A Eisenmenger, HD Eisenmenger. Discuss one by one. Then, okay, good.
Yes,
now I think Eisenmenger is more in India, no?